guys, it's Kelly, and I'm back again today with another recent reads. I have four books to talk about today. Two of them I listened to as audiobook, and two of them the physical book. And my ratings are really pretty varied on these. So I'm going to start with the one I like the least, and end with the one I like the best. And the first one is The Thief by Megan Wallen Turner. And this was a buddy read with Alex from Alex Black, so I'll link her channel down below. You should check her out. And Alex and I both had a really hard time getting through this book. It's actually pretty short, but and we were originally supposed to read it. We were going to read two chapters a day and be done, like, in less than a week. And I think it took us almost 3 weeks to finish this book. We just kept being like, I can't get into it, blah, blah, blah. And let me just really quick give you a summary of this. So this is about a thief named Jin, and he is in prison at the beginning and gets pulled out because his name is the Magus? I don't know how to say that word. Is it like a magician or I don't know. I still don't know after this book what this guy's job is. He's somebody that works for the king, and he has a name that starts with an M. Anyways, he pulls Jin out of prison and wants him to come with him to steal this, like, old sacred item called the gift, and it is supposed to give, like, immortality to the king or queen that wears it, and so he's supposed to steal it for the king. And most of this is basically just a journey book. And so I ended up giving this 2.5 stars. And I want to preface this say that if you are love this book and love this series, that I am actually still going to continue on this series. So that's kind of weird, because I would never usually continue on a series that I rated less than 3 stars. But the thing with this book, and from everything I've read in reviews and heard from people, is that this is basically just the setup for the rest of the series. So I think at this time there are 5 books in the series, because there was original quartet, and then she just came out with a new book. So there's 5 books in the series, and almost universally the reviews say that this is just like the setup, and everything from here gets much more exciting, much more political intrigue and all that. So I'm going to read the next book and give it a chance, because I really do think that this was an interesting setup. The book itself was just pretty boring to read because it is all introduction. Like, there's not much plot happening. We're getting introduced to the king and the thief and all of those characters. But for the most part, it is basically just the longest, most boring journey ever. Like, the, like, actual, any plot doesn't really happen until, like, the last 3 chapters. So, even though it's a short book, it took me so long to get through it. But I did like the main character, Jin, and I think that he takes a big part in the rest of the books, because the series is called the Queen's Thief series. So I think it's going to continue to follow him. So I am interested to follow him. I just did not like this whole journey setup thing, and we're getting introduced to the world and all that. So I think I would have preferred this to have just been like the beginning of the next novel, and made the next novel a little longer, cut this down, and just combine it all together. But I think she was just trying to like get out some of that world building out of the way, but just didn't put enough plot in it. So I don't want to turn you off from the series, because like I said, a lot of people love this series and say that it gets so much better. But this first book was just a slog to get through. So I will hopefully read the second one soon, and we'll let you know if it is worth getting through this to move on. So that was my thoughts on that one. And then my next book is a 4-star, and it is A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. And obviously everybody knows what this is about Scrooge and his visits from the three spirits. And I had never read this book. I mean, obviously I've seen some movie adaptations, so I knew what the story was about, but I never actually read the classic. And I've always just kind of avoided Dickens, thinking he'd be hard to read. And so that's why I was like, well, I'll start with the short one that's like Christmassy, and we already know the story. And I actually found his writing really fun. Like, there are times when he's super witty in this, and especially towards the beginning when it's still like not, I mean, we haven't gotten to like the third spirit, who's much more dark. But at the beginning, there were some really funny lines. And I really enjoyed his wit that Dickens put in, so I think I would like to read one of his longer novels and see if that is just kind of his style. And so I really enjoyed this. I gave it a 4 because I know it's a novella, so you can't really expect a ton, but I wanted more from the story because it seemed like Scrooge, he had 3 spirits to get through, but it seemed like he turned around really early on, like early in the book, even like in the first spirit, he was starting to say like, I need to change my ways and stuff like that. And I'm like, it's a little early, like you still got a lot of book left or novella left to like get that change and that redemption arc. So it didn't feel so much like an arc as like whoop and then a plateau. So I would have liked it to have been a slower redemption arc in the story. But I do recommend it because it gave me all the Christmassy feels and made me want to like watch one of the movies. And then the next one I don't have because I listened to an audiobook, and that was Sadie by Courtney Summers. And I, like I said, listened to this on audiobook, and I think that that is totally the way to go. People say that, and I've heard that, but I definitely think so because the book in itself, I think I would have rated it closer to a 3.5, 4, but I ended up giving it a 4.5, and I think that was because of the audiobook experience. And Sadie is a young adult novel about a girl named Sadie who her sister had died previously, like before the book starts. And this is the story of her trying to hunt down her sister's killer and get revenge. And so like we kind of learn about her sister's death, and we also learn about Sadie's background and their relationship and all that stuff. And it's told in 2 parts. It's told through Sadie's point of view and through a podcast. And the reason I think it's an excellent audiobook is it's a full cast audiobook with like a real podcast sounding kind of vibe to it. And if you are somebody that likes the podcast Serial, this is like Serial in book form, but then we also get from the perspective of the person that is like starring in the podcast. So I thought it was excellent. I am a fan of true crime type podcasts, and so this podcast in the book, the fictional one, seemed like something that I would totally listen to if it was a real podcast. And I loved it. I loved the narrator for the podcast and that whole like interview thing. It's just something I just like. It's like my guilty pleasure. I just like love true crime podcasts. And then I did enjoy Sadie's point of view. The reason I would have rated the book itself lower is that I expected it to go farther. And I don't mean like the ending, because some people don't really love the ending, and I'm not like worried about an ending where we don't get all the answers. I'm not concerned about that. It was more, I just wanted more from Sadie as a character, a little more about her past, and a little more maybe just like about her sister's murder, maybe. I don't know. I just wanted more from the actual story, but the podcast experience would have been like 5 stars. So I kind of like, I compromise and say 4.5 stars because I thoroughly enjoyed my experience, but I expected a little more from the story. But I would recommend it if you are somebody that loves podcasts and listen to the audiobook. And then my last one is As You Wish, Inconceivable Tales from the Making of the Princess Bride by Cary Elwes. And I also listened to this on audiobook. I had bought this book a while ago, and when I hauled it, one of my subscribers, I believe it was Alex Black, the girl that I had buddy with this month, she told me that I should listen to the audiobook. And so I was like, well, even though I already own this, I'm gonna give the audiobook a try. And I'm so glad. And if you're gonna read this book, I think you should do the audiobook, because it is narrated by Cary Elwes, who has an amazing voice to begin with, but it also has a lot of the other cast members and like the director and producer having their voice in there too. So we hear from Rob Reiner, the director, and Carol Kane and Billy Crystal and Wallace Shawn and a lot of the other actors from the movie do little interview parts in the audiobook. And so you get to hear all of those people. And since I am a huge fan of the Princess Bride movie, it felt like getting to really get behind the scenes and like hear from the experience. Loved it. So this is basically just him, a short memoir kind of thing of that time of his life when he was filming the movie. It goes all the way from when he is cast, like him meeting with Rob Reiner and the producer and getting the part, to things that happen on the set, and then like afterwards too. So like we get to meet the costume person and talk to like about props and the fencing. Like there's a whole big thing about him learning the fencing part, and him and Mandy Patinkin, and I loved that part, and like just stunts and all that kind of stuff. So if you're someone that loves the Princess Bride movie, you should definitely read this or listen to it. I think listen to it. And I flew by this really quick, through this really quickly, because I just like adored hearing all the behind the scenes stuff. I love this movie so much. Like I didn't watch it in theaters because I would have been too young, but I grew up watching it on VHS, you know, and DVD. But then like a few years ago, my husband's boss, who also loves The Princess Bride, the movie was coming back to theaters for like 1 weekend only as like one of those Fathom events. If you're in the States, you might know about that. They like go into theaters and they do like operas or Broadway shows or older movies. They bring them back for just like 1 weekend. And his boss, since he is so like obsessed with the movie, he offered for any of his employees that he would pay for the movie tickets to go. And he also paid for like our dinner and for a babysitter. So we're like, yeah, we're gonna go because it's like a free date night. And I was like, is the movie gonna hold up? Because I've never seen it in theaters. It's also like over 20 years after the movie came out. Like maybe it's only good on the small screen. But no, it totally held up. I thought it was excellent. I mean, it's just a classic story, you know, sword fighting and pirates and love and betrayal and comedy and just amazing. So highly recommend. Probably one of my favorite books of the year. I just adored it. So those are my books. They range quite a bit lately, but I still enjoyed the experience of all of them. Even The Thief, which wasn't like my favorite and I had a lot of problems with it, I did enjoy the ending and want to keep going. So I feel like that's a pretty successful like couple weeks of reading. So I will see you guys later. Bye.